Hey, Bedros Kulian here, and I'm a fitness marketing expert, which pretty much means I help personal trainers grow their business, get more clients, and of course, make more money in the fitness industry. Now, I've been doing this for, well over 10 years, and I've helped over 6,500 personal trainers with my information products. I've helped over 300 people through my coaching and mastermind and mentorship programs take their business to six, multiple six, and even seven figures. And what's really exciting about that is, through this time, I've not only done it myself with my own personal training businesses back in San Diego, but I've done it with so many of my coaching clients that I get to see what works on a consistent basis and what doesn't. And what I want to talk to you about today is how to build a personal training business kind of on a budget, right? I mean, who doesn't want to grow their business on a budget? And the big levers that I want to talk to you about are these. Number one, the very first thing you want to focus on is identifying who your niche market is. Now, if you think you're going to train anybody, male and female, between the ages of 8 and 80, you're absolutely wrong. There's probably a specific avatar who is a great fit for you. That might be, you know, stay-at-home moms. It might be busy executives. It might be athletes. Who knows what they are, right? But you probably know who your ideal client is. And what you've got to do is identify them and then say, okay, where can I find them in my community? Now, do you find them if they're moms, they're stay-at-home moms? Do they take their kids to the Jungle Gym, right? The Jungle Gym franchise down the street. Do they take their kids to, a daycare locally that you can go and have a strategic partnership with? Now that you know who your avatar is, you can go to the places that moms hang out to or hang out at or do business with and ask them to help promote your product and or your services. Now, why would they do this? Like, why would a daycare promote your personal training business? Real simple, because you're going to share part of their revenue on the front end with them. What that means is you're going to go to a local business that these moms frequent to. And what I would do if I were you, I'd make a list of all those businesses in the community. I'd go to them and say, hey, my name is Bedros Kulian, and I own the local personal training studio down the street. And what I'd like to do is, number one, offer you free personal training for the next, 30 days so you can try us out, see what we're all about. Totally on me. You can lose as much weight as you want in the next 30 days. Number two, I'd like to let my clients and customers and prospects know about your business because they might want to come and get a tan. They might want to get their hair done. They might want to bring their kids to your daycare. And number three, I was wondering if you would promote my special offer. I've got this 14-day fat furnace program for $67. And I was wondering if you could promote that to your email list or your customer list. And if you would, I would gladly give you 50% of all the revenue that comes from that promotion. Why do you want to give that revenue away? Well, we don't care about the revenue at all on the front end. We just want the customers, the clients, right? And then in those 14 days, you're going to get those people to know, like, and trust you, and then have your opportunity to convert them into ongoing clients where you keep all the money and give them amazing results. So what I would do first is make a big list of strategic partners that you can partner with. Number two, don't ever forget about the handy dandy direct mail piece. Everybody these days that's in fitness is marketing on the web, right? I want to get more leads from Facebook. I want to get more leads from email marketing. I want to get more leads from Google. All great, all effective. However, the tried and true direct mail piece is still super effective and relatively cheap. Let me give you an example. We sent out 2,500 of these postcards to targeted homes that had women with upper middle income, with houses worth more than $400,000, and they were within 5 miles of the facility that we were marketing. We sent out 2,500 of these postcards. They did 25 or 3,500 for around $1,000. Now that is a really good deal, right? That is a really good deal. You can go to Vistaprint.com and have a whole bunch of these postcards made, right? And they'll even crash the crash your return address on there for you if you want, right? And you just put on the addresses as you buy them and you mail them out. Now, what do you put on the postcard and where do you get the addresses? Simple. The postcard has to have a low barrier offer. So you're not going to promote some high-end expensive personal training or bootcamp service. You're going to promote five, maybe 10 personal training sessions or a 2-week 14-day fat furnace program for under $100. We found that the sweet spot is sub $100 to get people into your program. Let them try it out, right? Now, how do you find the ideal candidates to send these postcards to? Simple. You go to infousa.com and you can actually search out by criteria. Show me people, women who are within 3 miles of my fitness facility, who have upper middle income incomes and who live in homes above $400,000. And InfoUSA.com will actually show you that, right? The other way to do this is if you have a relationship with a real estate agent, and that real estate agent will have access to the MLS. And MLS is a site where real estate agents can go to and pull up other addresses for your area. They can tell you which homes are worth X amount of dollars. And you can say, show me homes that are $400,000 or more. And they can actually give you either a spreadsheet that you can then crash the addresses on the postcard. And some of them could even give you the actual peel and stick address labels of these homes absolutely free. It's a long story, but the title company that they work with will actually give them the address labels absolutely free. Now, you do have to have a relationship with a real estate agent to get this to work for you, because quite frankly, I don't think just any real estate agent off the street will do that for you. But those are the two ways you get addresses, and those are the two ways that you grow your personal training business on a bootstrap income. And the third and final way is, once you get clients into your boot camp, the next thing you're going to do, or your personal training facility for that matter, is you're going to run referral contests. You're going to, right off the bat, make it a condition of doing business with you. Referrals have to be a condition of doing business with you. So how do you do this? You first and foremost, when you welcome Mrs. Jones on board, hey, Mrs. Jones, welcome aboard. Over the next few months, as I help you get in the most amazing shape of your life, can I help you? Can I ask you to help me achieve my business goals, which are to help more people like you, your friends, family, coworkers, and neighbors? So can I ask for your referrals as I give you amazing results? They're going to shake hands and say, yes, of course. Now you can send out handwritten thank you cards once a month with a little statement that says, hey, I'm never too busy for your referral. You can hand out plastic gift cards. Say, hey, this week, if you give these $50 gift cards out, I'll double them if your clients bring them back and make it $100 worth of training for them, right? You can have referral contests where the winner, person who sends you the most referrals this week, the client, gets a free iPad, right? I mean, you could run referral contests all day long, and you can find a whole bunch of examples of referral contests on my blog if you just click the link right down below, ptpower.com, and I've got a ton of free fitness marketing stuff for you. But just want you to think outside of the box moving forward, and don't just think about getting clients from the web or from one specific isolated area. Have multiple poles in the water, and you're going to find that your business is more predictable, more reliable, and more profitable. I'll see you later.